Okay, here's a good point. Which USMLE step would be considered the most important for residency applications?
Only step 1, 2, and 3.
Okay.
That's it. Step 1, 2, and 3.
That's it.
I think that it's, I couldn't choose one or the other. I think
they're all
that,
important, yeah.
I think that it's better to have at least one excellent one than maybe two mediocre ones, because then you could say somebody can ascend. Is a one-hit wonder in music better than a no-hit person? I think so.
So, great point. What if somebody got a 220, for example, or 225 in step one, and then they get a 250 on step two?
I think it shows an awful lot that I'd rather have somebody that can hit the mountaintop once.
Okay. So that's a...
Also, I believe in redemption. What about people who actually failed before? And I go, if you pass, you better pass big.
Gotcha.
You better pass big.
You can't just squeak by. You
can't
have to
just squeak
blow
by.
It out of the water.
You can go by and say, well, you know, I failed the first time.
I had a headache that day.
But on the second time, I got a 250. I was abducted by aliens. I had explosive diarrhea. It wasn't my fault.
Then
actually,
you can
let me
get
make that as a point about things. You know what the thing that is so disturbing about people is that when people don't do well, instead of saying, because how do you address an interview if you don't do well in one? You just say like this. You're absolutely right. I wish I'd done better. I'm disappointed too.
Address it
and you say, I'm disappointed too. Don't make excuse about it. You know, and what do I hear instead?
My dog died that day.
I have testicular anxiety. It's like 94% of people have testicular anxiety. And here are very legitimate. My mother died. My father died. My wife left me. My husband left me. I found out I took a couple of residents from Syria because they managed to proceed and develop even despite obstacles. The next day, a guy came in and he goes, well, I did very badly because there's a conflict in my country. There's a war going on. And I go, well, I can certainly understand that. But I got two Syrian guys, Pakistan, Nigeria, these other places, Lebanese, Palestinian territories, and you go, they performed. You got to perform. You got to perform.
That does not sound
like I'm sorry for the difficulties that you have in your life. I'm sorry. But you have to perform. These other guys did. I said men and women. They did. So you can't make excuses like, I had this personal tragedy, you know, or I have this anxiety. Because what it really is saying to people, and the program directors will never tell you this to your face, is they're really saying, I just want you to know that if I have any form of personal emotional difficulty.
I'm going to fold.
Oh, say it again?
I'm going to fold.
I just want you to know that I can't perform under personal emotional difficulty. And I can't function. And by the way, if I have a patient that's sick and I screw up the treatment, I'll let them know that my father got leukemia. It's like, well, you have to perform.
Absolutely.
You have to perform.
What's going to happen when you're an intern and the patient crashes in front of you? That's pressure.
Yeah.
You have to deal with that.
You have to deal with it. I don't, for some people that's made sound harsh, but it's just the way it is.
I couldn't agree more.
No.
Couldn't agree more. Thank you. Okay, I think you already answered this, but what about...
Let's expressly address the failure issue.
Yes.
I think that number one thing is, I gave a contract to a guy this year because when he failed once, he passed big. But the other thing about it is he didn't make excuses. He said like this, I know I didn't do well, I was really disappointed. I was shocked when it happened. And I will not let you down. I will not let you down. And I will make it. And I will rise up because I'm not going to embarrass myself or let you down if you take me. And I gave him the contract.
Very good. That's a nice story. Very nice story. Yeah. So it's good to hear that there is hope if you fail, but you just have to do the right thing, right?
Yeah.
And he did very well the second time.
And they did well the second time. But the other point is it turned out to be a very, very hard-working, decent intern.
That's great to hear.
You know, I'll tell you who did not get something from me. A guy who got modest scores the first time. And then I go, look, you have a 210. But you see, there's a person right down the hall there. I know you come by 10 times. But there's a young lady right there, she had a 235. Do you think that your score and her score are the same? And he goes, yeah, it's all the same. Oh, wow, really? I said, okay, I'll tell you what it is. You've been here 10 times knocking on my door. So I'll tell you what. If you can go walk up to that woman and you go tell her that you deserve the score and not you deserve the position more than her, and you have a 210 and she's got a 235, you tell her you deserve the spot, because I'm not going to tell her. If you can do it, I'll give you the spot. You go up and tell her I deserve your spot because you got a score that's 30 points above me and 25 points above me, but you don't deserve it, I do. He goes, I can't do that.
Oh, well.
That's it.